flips it up and heads. Skating forward, the shot on goal deflected. Put back in goal for Allie Morris of the Liberty Flames. Striking first here early. Liberty was pushing their advantage. Initial shot stopped and deflected by Schreiber, but Allie Morris with a great follow-through and was able to put it back on the rebound. If you have another look at it here.
That's great awareness right there by Morris. Noticing that the puck was loose in the crease. That's something that you're going to want to look for as a hockey player. You got to want to get in there and get close to the goal.
Bringing along the far side boards, dumps it back off to Demerchant. Demerchant looking for something, drops it to Manchuk. Manchuk trying to get in. 5 seconds left in the power play. Shot on goal! That looks like it's a goal for Manchuk.
Ooh, I don't know how she snuck that one in there.
Great opportunity there for Liberty there as they're able to convert with just seconds left to go in the power play.
Incredible.
As we see, she weaves it and bobs it in there and just able to get it. Looked like just over the glove of Schreiber.
Oh, this is just a beautiful goal. Threads the needle straight through.
Tries to send it along the backside of the boards. Collected by Mackles. Mackles here with it. Sending, looking for something. McLeod here. Fires it to the middle, right into the back of the net. What a shot by McLeod.
Wow. Fired off a strong wrister there from the top.
Take another look here at the replay. Looked like Schreiber just didn't pick up the puck as it was fired. One look about over her right skate and under her stick arm. 5 seconds left here in the power in the 5-on-3 power play. Sit down to Poulsen. Poulsen back out to Demerchant. Demerchant shot good. That is a goal for Vanessa Demerchant as Liberty is able to take advantage of the play right there.
That is her sixth goal on the season, make up for her 11th point total as she has 5 assists.
Take a look at this replay. Great play there for Liberty. Demerchant sends it down to Poulsen. Poulsen right back to Demerchant with that little 1-2 touch right there. The puck finds its way into the back of the net. There to Pelizzari. She had 2 last night.
Pelizzari and Poulsen.
Yeah. And so what happened there is it was still technically 5-on-4 hockey as Mackles, with an opportunity, is able to flip it up and in early. Wow, this period is quickly turning into a nightmare here for the Midland Warriors. That was a very quick opportunity there. Looks like Mackles just tried to flip it up and in. Schreiber was able to get her glove on it, but wasn't able to squeeze it in there, and it looked like it just dribbled right over the top of her glove.
That was a very nice, quick goal here. See, she flicks up the wrist.
Yeah, it looks like it was deflected. Schreiber would tell you she knows she should have had that one, but regardless, it's still 5-0 here score at the Lehigh Ice Center. The name of the game for Liberty has been the second period so far in this series that they've had this weekend.
Yeah, in the first game, they scored 7 goals in the second period. Second game, which was last night, they scored 4 goals, and today they scored 3 in the second period.
Another goal here for Liberty. Second period or not, they've been effective, and it looks like they got another goal here early, just over 2 minutes here into the third period. Looks like no one was quite sure what happened until the referee pointed to the net. And looks like Midland Warriors they're deflated at this point. Looked like there was a scuffle in front of the goal before they were finally able to put it back in. Pressured, gives it back up to Pierce. Pierce tries to flip it down to Poulsen. Poulsen in the middle with the backhand. Tries for the opportunity, goal! Great shot there for number 16, Danica Poulsen.
Poulsen with a couple assists on the day, but I believe it's her first goal as she gets right in front of the net. We'll take another look. There's the Poulsen rebound shot.
Looked like a great feed there by Morris, I want to say. Fancy stick work there by Bradford.
That would have been beautiful. And there it is.
And it looks like Allie Morris is going to convert on her second goal of today's game after some big plays there by Shelby Bradford. Take a look at it here. Bradford knocks it, tries to poke it out. Is Schreiber not able to get in it?
Morris, right place, right time on that one. Beautiful rebound goal. Skates right in and slides it into the right side of the goalie.
Bernie looking for something, flips to the middle. Puck knocked around a little bit in front of the goal. Couple players down on the ice. Coming away with it. Poulsen able to find the back of the net again. Wow, have yourself a game, Danica Polson. Little bit of scuffle, puck got lost, came out, right place, right time. Polson put a nice shot on it. Was able to find the back corner of the net.
That's a great heads-up play. A lot of traffic there. And she was able to squeeze it in just one of the few open lanes that were available.
It looked like she wrapped it around one of the defensive players for the Midland Warriors. And time will expire for Liberty to get a shot off. So far, Liberty absolutely dominant so far in their season. 9-0 victory here today as they were able to lay up another goose egg against the Midland Warriors. And Nadia Rapoli secures her fifth shutout in goal this season, capping off an absolute dominant season so far.
Brings the record for the Flames to 13-1, and the Midland Warriors drop to 8-5.
Yeah, as you just saw there on your screen, absolutely dominant offensive game for them as well. I mean, so far, Truder got a goal tonight, Allie Morris with two, Dana Compulson with two, Dana McLeod with one, the Merchant with one. Absolute dominant offensive performance today for them. And you know, like you said, it's a learning experience. These teams may see each other again soon, and if not this season, they'll see each other next season multiple times as they're going to be in the same conference again for multiple years to come, most likely. This is Liberty Hockey here, where they come away with the victory 9-0. My name is Dylan Urino. My partner, Jared Dean, wishing you a good evening, and God bless.